الحمد لله الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على محمد وعلى آله وصحبه الطاهرين الطيبين وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن محمدا رسول الله أما بعد فيا أيها الناس اتقوا الله وسارعوا إلى مغفرته ورضاه فإنه من مات على الحق فقد رشد وإنه من مات على الباطل فقد خاب وخسر خسر الدنيا وخسر الآخرة وذلك هو الخسران المبين. Human brain is something amazing. It has more than 68 billion neuron cells, and it weighs 3 to 3.3 pounds. But it is better than any computer on the earth. You can store information as much as you can. In fact, alhamdulillah, we have people who memorize Quran. They just store it. In our imam meeting of America and Canada, I met an imam from Arizona. He memorized the whole Sahih of Bukhari and Muslim. It's not only the hadith, but even the chain. So the fuqaha, the scholars of Islam, sometimes if they are confused, they call him. And he will give you the right, the correct hadith, the chain, everything. So what happened in our brain, there are folders, files. And whenever we want to think about something, we will pull this file or a folder. And it would take only milliseconds to bring it down. And some of us can memorize 20, 30 years ago what happened. For example, if I say, do you remember your country? Immediately. With milliseconds, you will remember the country, you remember old house, your grandfather, your grandmother. But it's amazing that if I ask you, what did you eat last month at dinner? Nothing. You can't. So it looks like the important information, you keep it for years. The not important information, you lose it. Now, these folders, there are thousands in your brain. And I will give you examples. If I mention Allah, you will immediately right now bring in the folder of Allah. Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, you bring it. Today, I'm going to talk about one folder that's a little bit complicated, but I wanted to make it simple. And when I was giving, preparing the khutbah, my wife, she said, what are you going to talk about? I said, about the grave. She said, no, please. So she pulled the folder. That's a terrible thing. You're going to scare people. You're going to scare kids. I said, that's your folder. Well, let's go to the folder of the Quran and Sunnah. My folder is different, totally. So, most of the Muslims, unfortunately, they have this folder, is like terror, darkness in the grave, punishment, snakes, scorpions, and all kind of punishment. Of course, this comes from where? It comes from our parents, from culture, from environment, reading some books, reading some articles on the internet, or sometime we have some imams who scare us to death from adab al-qabr. There's punishment in the grave and so. The problem is, if we have this imagination or thinking about the punishment in the grave, that causes big problem for Muslims, and especially our kids in America. Because immediately it reflects your relationship with Allah. the grave is going to be punishment, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be portraying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as a punisher, God. Which is, I cannot find, it is Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, the most merciful. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants the Muslims, the believer, to establish a relationship on love and mercy. And this is huwa al-asas. This is the asas. This is the correct. It is not your relationship or my relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala based on fear. No. Now, I went and read the Quran and the Hadith, and there are 10 types or kinds of happiness in the grave for the Muslims, for the believers. If you are a Muslim, if you believe in Quran and Muhammad and the Messenger of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, wallahi, don't afraid. I'm going to give you from the Quran and from the Sunnah. It's amazing. But some people will say, well, there are some punishments. It's not for Muslims. I challenge you. You go read the Quran and all the Hadith and bring me an ayah or a Hadith saying that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will punish a believer. All the punishment will be on the criminals. Exactly, the criminals, the killers, the stealers, the thieves, the cheaters, those are in jail. Right now, if you go to the jail, whom do you see? A respected Muslim physician or respected, but no. All these are criminals. So once I found out, once we die and we are in the grave, and you know how to answer these simple three questions by the angels. Man huwa rabbuk, who is your Lord? Anyone can say Allah. Exactly. Ma huwa dinuk, what is your religion? Islam. Ma huwa, man huwa nabiyuka, who is your Prophet Muhammad? It's very simple. Even Umar ibn Khattab, he said to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in the grave, do we have our brain with us? He said, yes. He said, well, that's easy. That's easy. Now, when you pass these questions, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has, this is a hadith, sahih. فَيُفْسَحْ لَهُ فِي قَبْرِهِ كَمَدِّ الْبَصْرِ. Your grave will be enlarged. كَمَدِّ الْبَصْرِ. In a hadith akhar, 70 by 70 ذِرَاعِ. Widen, 70 by 70 arm length. So it's huge. وَيُنَوُّرْ لَهُ فِي قَبْرِهِ. And your grave will be enlightened. Light. And this is really what will happen to the Muslims and believers. Who are those people who they pray, they are good manners, they give zakah, they give charity. These are the people. They fast. Look at your father and mother, how they lived. They understood this is Islam, very simple. And they go and they die with confidence. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran to the believers, مَا يَفْعَلُ اللَّهُ بِعَذَابِكِمْ مَا يَفْعَلُ اللَّهُ بِعَذَابِكُمْ إِن شَكَرْتُمْ وَآمَنْتُمْ. What Allah does with your punishment. If you thank him and believe in him, he doesn't want to punish us. Adab al-Qabr, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, it is not for the Muslims. It is not for the believers. In Surah Al-Qalam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, أَفَنَجْعَلُ الْمُسْلِمِينَ كَالْمُجْرِمِينَ. Do we treat Muslims like criminals? No. Another, أَفَنَجْعَلُ الْمُتَّقِينَ كَالْمُجْرِمِينَ. Do we treat believers, muttaqeen, as criminals? مَا لَكُمْ كَيْفَ تَحْكُمُونَ. How can you do such judgment? No. Mujrimeen, criminals, are different than the Muslims and the believers. In fact, the Prophet ﷺ said, look at how when they ask him about al-qabr, he starts with positives. يقول, القبر روضة من رياض الجنة. Now this is in Al-Tirmidhi. The grave is like rawdah. You know what's a rawdah? If you go to Al-Madinah Al-Munawwara and you go to the and visit the Prophet ﷺ grave, there is rawda between his house and his member, the green carpet. You sit there with peace, enjoyment. Allah, the Prophet says, this is your position as a believer, as a Muslim, rawda. It is a peaceful place. You stay in the grave and you enjoy. Now, he continues, the Prophet ﷺ, he says, when the Muslim is placed in his grave, or the believer, فَفْرُشُوا لَهُ مِنَ الْجَنَّةِ. So this is 70 by 70, and the Prophet ﷺ says, they're gonna furnish the furniture from Jannah. وَأَلْبِسُوهُ مِنْ لِبَاسِ الْجَنَّةِ. Your clothes, your outfit will be from the Jannah. I'm not talking about the criminals. And when the Prophet ﷺ was asked about the grave, he said, أَوَّلُ مَنَازِلْ الْجَنَّةِ. The first step of Jannah. Yani what? Yani imagine that you receive a letter in the mailbox. You open the letter, you have been promoted at work. That is the glad tidings in the grave. But actually, when you go to your workplace, you will see your place, your furniture, your room, that is, the Prophet ﷺ is saying, it is the glad tidings, the first step. خَالِدِينَ فِيهَا. Now, in the grave, there is something here I found. It's like three dimension. What I mean? If you have done any good things, the Prophet ﷺ says, this deed, this good deed, comes as a person. Comes as a person? Yes. He comes good looking, beautiful, as a person. That is your good deed. Yani, for example, you have sponsored an orphan. You gave the money to one of the agency here, organization, they paid, and you don't know, and you forgot. But in the grave, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will show you your money, where did it go? How this orphan grew up with your money, spent, maybe he became a doctor, maybe he's, and you enjoy it. He enjoyed it because the Prophet ﷺ says, يَأْتِي فِي الْقَبْرِ رَجُلٌ حَسَنُ الْمَظْهَرِ حَسَنُ الْمَلْبَسِ فَيَقُولُ مَنْ أَنْتَ فَيَقُولُ أَنَا عَمَلُكَ الصَّالِحِ. You will see a person, very nice person, and you will ask, who are you? He says, I'm your good deed. Three dimension. And you will enjoy it. You will look. So this is why. آمَنُوا وَعَمَلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ. The more amal salih you do, the more enjoyment you are going to see in the grave. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي وأستغفر. الحمد لله، الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على محمد وعلى آله وصحبه الطاهرين. Can we come forward? There are a lot of brothers standing there. Maybe we can give them space. This is Amal Saleh. This is a good deed. Especially with, today is the first day of Dhul Hijjah. Wonderful 10 days. Best days for Muslims. Be careful not to do any sins. Do anything you want. Read Quran. Pray. Help people. Donate. Udhiyah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is giving us these 10 days. Just to put us in paradise. In the grave, تصلك الهدايا. You will receive gifts. How? How am I going to receive gifts? وولد صالح يدعو لك. You have a child that he remembers you after you die. And he say, رب ارحمهما كما ربياني صغيرا. He makes dua for you. You will receive it as a gift. A friend that remembers you. I say, Allah yarhamu. He was a good man. He receives as a gift. Gift after gift. and you will receive gifts from people that you don't know. You have a son that he goes to Umrah or Hajj and he makes Umrah for you. Plenty of gifts comes to you while you are in the grave. Now how long are we going to stay in the grave? The hadith says it's very limited time for Muslims, for believers. It's very limited time. And all of it, happiness. There is nothing punishment for the believer. There is nothing to scare the kids here. That is, there is a snake and scorpions and then you're going to, darkness is nothing. But the condition is to be a Muslim. Pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is why al-Muslim al-Mu'min, he is in the grave asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what kind of dua? Ya Rab Aqim Sa'a, O Allah, let the day of judgment come. Yes, because he is getting the pleasure of the grave, he wants the pleasure of the Jannah. Aqim Sa'a, O Allah, this is my dua. Let the day of judgment come. On the opposite, يقول المجرم, the criminal, he says, Ya Rab la taqum sa'a. Oh Allah, do not let the day of judgment come. These are the criminals. Because they know what they are doing. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, A'udhu billahi min ash-shaytan rajim. If you love Allah, just love Allah. He says, الَّذِينَ تَتَوَفَّاهُمُ الْمَلَائِكَةِ طَيِّبِينَ. The translation, the angels of death takes their souls. Those are talking about the good people. What is good people? Imams? Scholars? No. Just be good. Yeah, like your father and mother and grandfather and grand... Don't. طَيِّبِينَ. طَيِّبِينَ in Arabic, you are a good person. You don't cause trouble. You love your brother. You love your sister. You sacrifice. This is tayyibin. The sense, the essence of Islam is mercy. This hadith, I end up my khutbah. ورد عن أنس. أنس رضي الله عنه says, قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. This is a hadith in Tirmidhi وابن ماجه وصححه الألباني. And the number of the hadith is 6,275. Very, very beautiful hadith. يقول النبي من سأل الله الجنة ثلاث مرات قالت الجنة اللهم ادخله الجنة. If you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala three times, O Allah, put me in Jannah, the Jannah will say, O Allah, enter him Jannah. وَمَنْ اسْتَجَارَ مِنَ النَّارِ ثَلَاثْ مَرَّاتِ Three times, قَالَتِ النَّارِ اللَّهُمَّ جُرْهُ مِنَ النَّارِ And if you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to protect you from hellfire, the fire will say, Oh Allah, protect him from me. You know, when you ask who the creator of the heavens and earth, and the creator of Jannah, and the creator of hellfire. When you say, Allahumma inni as'aluka al-jannah wa a'udhu bika min an-nar, protect me from the hellfire. The fire itself, say, I cannot put you in the fire because you asked my creator. So my point here, brothers and sisters, we have to change the folder that some people, they have it. It is a corrupted, it has a virus in this folder, fire. We need to polish it, because if you live under this fear, you are not going to have a good relationship with your Creator. Your relationship with the Creator, love and mercy. You pray because you love Him, not because I'm afraid of Him. If I'm afraid of Him, that's a problem. Think about it. اللهم اغفر لنا وارحمنا واهدنا وعافنا واعف عنا اللهم انت ربي لا اله الا انت او الله you are my lord there is no god except you خلقتني وأنا عبدك وعلى عهدك ووعدك ما استطعت. You have created me and I am your servant. I hold your covenant as far as I can. أعوذ بك من شر ما صنعت. I seek refuge in you from the evil of what I have done. وأبوء لك بنعمتك علي. I acknowledge the favors that you have bestowed on me. وأبوء لك بذنبي فاغفر لي ذنبي فإنه لا يغفر الذنوب إلا أنت. Pardon me, Allah. For none but you has the power to forgive. وأقم الصلاة يرحمني.